At 1:43 p.m. on the afternoon of Wednesday, the 24th of May, President Yoweri Museveni issued the Executive Order No. 3 of 2023 via his Twitter page. In this executive order, the president bans all charcoal burning and trade in northern and northeastern Uganda, covering the subregions of Teso, Karamoja, Lango, West Nile, and Acholi. The issuance of the Executive Order No. 3 by President Yoweri Museveni came 10 days after the Chief Justice Owiny Dolo called the charcoal business in northern Uganda a syndicate to desertify the region. The Chief Justice, who was speaking during the burial of former Minister of State for Labor Okello Charles Engola in Oyam District, extended his appreciation to the former Aru County Member of Parliament Odonga Samuel Otto for leading the fight against the charcoal business.
At this point, my younger brother, Odomoto, is always stopping them on the way. I'm told he's now being charged with robbery. But I have not had anybody who's destroying our environment being charged.
Odonga Otto, who has been filmed on several occasions deflating the tires of vehicles carrying charcoal, has also welcomed a timely executive order from President Yoweri Museveni.
Give me the lances. Give me your papers, I see. You are using money to bribe the police. So show me your paper, I say, Ganda. I would say sorry.
However, despite the excitement on the streets of Gulu City and the surrounding areas, the local people and their leaders are waiting for the directives on how the executive order will be implemented.
That for us, we have, as the Repepe Party, we have just become environmental activists. With or without the directives, we were busy stopping trucks, intercepting them, distributing the charcoal. So the only difference now is that we are on the same side with the president.
While others like Andrew Obibi from Moro District are volunteering to implement the executive order, the chairperson of the Acholi parliamentary group, Anthony Akol, who is also the member of parliament representing the people of Kilak North in Amuru District, is concerned about the role of the security organs in the implementation.
He promised us that he's going to order or give his directive. Unfortunately, we've seen the directives. Our worry is how the action will take place, how exactly they are going to implement.
On the other hand, Odonga Otto has already formed a pressure group known as Ribe Pipachu in order to intensify the fight against the charcoal business.
A message to the people of Acholi: we are introducing a new concept called Makasai. We are killing ourselves. We will see the ultimate price in 10, 15 years. So we really have to stop this. We cannot afford to supply charcoal to the whole of Uganda.
But one of the reasons that has been identified for the continued charcoal trade in northern Uganda, especially in Acholi subregion, is the mistrust and disunity among political leaders.
People only wait for the charcoal loaded in the vehicle. When you stop a charcoal loaded in a vehicle, you are no longer preventing environmental degradation.
The escalation of charcoal business in northern Uganda can be traced back to the days of the Joseph Kony LRA insurgency, which forced residents to take refuge in the internally displaced people's camps.
We have been doing a lot. We raised the issues also on the floor of parliament on the issue of charcoal burning in northern Uganda. And we want to thank others who have joined hands with us. It is a joint effort. We don't need to, we can't afford to be disunited to handle this problem.
As a religious leader, Bishop James Ochan of the Born Again Churches in northern Uganda is requesting President Yoweri Museveni to identify a strong team that will implement the executive order.
I congratulate President, and I request that the appropriate responsible people begin to take action to ensure that the presidential directive is well implemented.
Read the directives. There are some loopholes that are glaring. Number one, for instance, he's not talking about logs. And number two, we also think the mechanism for enforcement is also not still elaborated. Although, as we understand it, it is meant to be gazetted, and of course, that is where we shall get the details from.
The RDCs are expected to play a big part in the implementation of the Executive Order No. 3 of 2023.
The ministries involved, the Ministry of Lands, the Ministry of Waters and Environment, Ministry of Internal Affairs, they need to put together manpower that is able to move into the bushes where these activities are taking place.
There are over 1,000 charcoal dealers operating in the 8 districts of Acholi sub-region. They are registered under the Uganda Charcoal Dealers Association.
Flush out the elements who are cutting down these trees. One in the person in the name of Hassan Ali Hassan has a license. Now, when somebody has a license, one of the things I have also asked and I sought the guidance of the Attorney General, his license should be revoked. With the coming into force of the executive order, the license should forthwith be revoked.
On the 24th of January 2023, the Minister of State for Environment, Beatrice Anyua, released a letter banning the issuance of all types of documents that facilitate the commercial production and trade of charcoal in the Acholi sub-region. Beyond the Acholi sub-region, the President's Executive Order No. 3 of 2023 extends to ban charcoal business in West Nile, Lango, Karamoja, and Teso. The story has been compiled by Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.